There are hundreds of treatments for painful neuropathy. Today, we're going to take a look at one specific drug, gabapentin, that has helped millions of people throughout the world manage their painful neuropathy. Let's examine how this drug works in painful neuropathy. Painful neuropathy, or chronic nerve pain, is a debilitating illness that affects millions of people around the world. Chronic nerve pain or painful neuropathy can arise when nerves become damaged from trauma, such as from motor vehicle accidents or falling or lacerations, or when nerves are pinched, compressed from herniated discs in the spine, as in sciatica. But nerves can also be damaged from other conditions, such as metabolic diseases like diabetes, or infections with viruses such as shingles, leading to postherpetic neuralgia. Or the nerves may be damaged from vitamin deficiencies, vitamin B12 deficiency, for example. But whatever the cause, people who suffer from chronic nerve pain, painful neuropathy, are eager to find a remedy because the pain profoundly impacts the quality of their lives. One treatment that has offered relief to millions of people around the world is the drug gabapentin. Originally intended as a medication to treat seizures, this drug has turned out to be one of the most effective treatments for peripheral neuropathy or painful neuropathy, chronic nerve pain. But just how gabapentin and its successor pregabalin exert their influence on the peripheral nerves and offer relief to patients suffering from painful neuropathy is still debated in scientific circles. Today, however, scientists believe that gabapentin binds to a receptor, an alpha-2 delta-1 receptor found on the surface of nerve cells. After binding to that receptor, the receptor causes channels known as voltage-gated channels to close. These are channels through which the calcium ions on the outside of the cell flow into the cell. And it is this influx of calcium into the nerve cell that causes the release of a substance in the joints between two cells known as the synapse. This substance, glutamate, is a neurotransmitter. A neurotransmitter is a substance that transmits an impulse from one nerve cell to the other. And when the level of glutamate falls in the synapse, in the connection between two nerve cells, the painful stimuli, the painful impulses, are no longer able to travel through the nerve tract, and the pain is blocked. Providers would usually start with a low dose of 300 milligrams of gabapentin on the first day and increase to 600 milligrams on the second day, to 900 milligrams on the third day, and progressively increase as needed to a maximum dose of 1800 milligrams a day. Gabapentin, however, sometimes requires up to 3 weeks of treatment before optimum relief is obtained. I hope you liked the video. If you did, support the channel by subscribing. Don't forget to like and share and press the notification bell so you can receive notification when new videos come out. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.